In the last lecture, we calculated the Fourier transform of triangular function, and in this lecture, we will calculate the Fourier transform of sampling function. We know sampling t is equal to sine t divided by t, but to calculate the Fourier transform, we will consider the general case of sampling function. So our time domain signal xt is equal to a naught sampling kt, and we are required to calculate the Fourier transform of this sampling function. Let's say the Fourier transform is x omega. So this is what we need to do. We can use the formula of Fourier transform, but the calculation involving the integrations will be lengthy. So we will use the property of duality, because we know the Fourier transform of rectangular function is having sampling function. We know the Fourier transform of a rect t over tau is equal to a tau multiplied to sampling omega tau by 2. So we have sampling function in the Fourier transform of the rectangular function, and let's say the rectangular function is yt. And now we will use the duality property. We want the sampling function in the time domain. So we will replace omega by t. This will give us a tau sampling t tau by 2. And this function will have the Fourier transform according to the duality property equal to 2 pi multiplied to yt when t is replaced by minus omega. So we have 2 pi multiplied to y minus omega. So this is the Fourier transform of the sampling function we are having. First, we will plot the waveform of the Fourier transform, and then we will find a naught and k. So let's quickly plot the waveform. The waveform is not very difficult to plot, because we know the waveform of rectangular function will look like this. The amplitude is equal to a. This time instant is equal to minus tau by 2. This time instant is equal to tau by 2. This is the waveform of rectangular function yt. And as we are replacing t by minus omega, we will change the time axis to the frequency axis, and the signal we are having is y minus omega. So first, we will replace the time axis by the frequency axis, and we will have y omega. Y omega will have the same waveform like yt, and we know from the waveform that it is an even signal. So after performing the reversal operation, we will have y minus omega with the same waveform, because even signals remain same after performing the reversal operation. But you can see 2 pi is multiplied to y minus omega. So we will multiply 2 pi, and we will have the similar type of waveform, but this time the amplitude will increase. The amplitude will be equal to 2 pi multiplied to a. This is minus tau by 2, tau by 2 omega 2 pi y minus omega. The amplitude is equal to 2 pi a. So this is the final waveform of the Fourier transform. And now we will quickly obtain the values of a naught and k. A naught on comparison is equal to a multiplied to tau, a multiplied to tau, and k on comparison is equal to tau by 2, tau by 2. So from here we can say that minus tau by 2 is equal to minus k. So we will have minus k and k, as the time instance between which the signal value is equal to 2 pi a. 2 pi a we can write as 2 pi multiplied to a naught by tau. A is equal to a naught by tau, and we know tau is equal to 2 times k. So in place of tau we will write 2k. 2 and 2 will cancel out. So finally 2 pi a is equal to pi multiplied to a naught by k. So in place of 2 pi a we will write pi multiplied to a naught by k. So remember the Fourier transform of the sampling function and the waveform of the Fourier transform. If you have any doubt, you may ask in the comment section. I will end this lecture here. See you in the next one.